Hi everyone, welcome to a new episode of Jeroen's Take. And today I will discuss why I think there is little upside left in bond yields. As you may know, I look at a lot of indicators within macro, sentiment and valuation to get an idea where markets are going. And virtually all of these indicators in macro, sentiment and valuation are telling me that bond yields should go down and not up. So let's look at macro first. As a general rule, bond yields increase when the economy strengthens and bond yields decline when the economy weakens. Now, with that in mind, let's look at this chart. It shows the ISM Manufacturing Index, which is the blue line, and the 10-year US Treasury yield, which is the green line. Most of the time, these lines move in the same direction. So when the ISM goes up, so goes the bond yield, and vice versa. The only distortion that we have seen is because of COVID, but I think there's no reason to believe that this relationship does not hold anymore. Now, what we have seen recently is that bond yields have gone up further, so the 10-year US Treasury yield is now above 3%, as the ISM Manufacturing Index actually has declined. So there's already a pretty big gap between the two. But that's not all. Some of my forward-looking indicators, they suggest that the ISM Manufacturing Index will go down further and it will bottom somewhere around 45. So imagine that in this chart, the ISM Manufacturing Index goes down to 45. It suggests that the 10-year US Treasury yield should go to 1% or even lower. Now, I don't think it will get that extreme, but it does give you a clear signal of how much downside there is for the 10-year US Treasury yield. So relative to the business sentiment in other parts of the world, the ISM Manufacturing Index is actually holding up pretty well. It looks much worse in, for example, Germany. The next chart shows the IFO Expectations Index, which is the green line, and German GDP growth, which is the blue line. The green line reflects that German businesses are extremely downbeat about the future. And it also suggests that German GDP on an annual basis should decline by 7 percentage points for the two lines to align. Now, most likely it won't get as worse as that, but yes, most likely we do get negative GDP growth in Germany. And that means there's downside pressure on bond yields. Obviously, the reason why central banks are hiking so aggressively is because inflation is still too high. But after months and months of higher than expected inflation numbers, things are turning. The number of indicators that suggest that inflation should come down significantly in the coming months and quarters are piling up quickly. The next chart shows inflation expectations of US businesses, which is the green line, against US realized headline inflation, which is the blue line. You see that inflation expectations have collapsed completely and are now near the levels seen during the Great Financial Crisis. And even if these inflation expectations are only half right, it means that inflation will come down significantly and also pressure bond yields going forward. But it's not just macro that points to lower bond yields. The next chart is from the Bank of America Global Fund Manager Survey. It's one of the most well-known investor surveys, and it does not only ask about the economy, but also about investor positioning. As the chart shows, on average, global fund managers are short equities and bonds, and they are overweight cash. Now, most of the time, when sentiment is positive, they will allocate some of that cash towards equities. And if sentiment is negative, they will allocate towards bonds. With a global recession coming, with an energy crisis, but also earnings expectations that are still way too high, I think sentiment will struggle. And that most likely means that these fund managers will allocate to bonds. More inflow into bonds means lower bond yields most of the time. So what about valuation? Well, here too, a lot of indicators suggest that bond yields should go down and not go up. The next chart shows a model estimate or fair value estimate of the 10-year US Treasury yield based on some of the well-known yield-driving indicators. Think, for example, about the Federal Reserve target rate, the Federal Reserve balance sheet, inflation, and unemployment. And for a long time, you see that this model estimate almost perfectly estimated how high the actual 10-year US Treasury yield should be, which is, by the way, the blue line. Only in recent years, a big gap has opened up. And this could be the case because investors are starting to believe that we are moving over in a new bond regime in which bond yields are structurally higher. I don't think this is the case. Just look at debt to GDP ratios of governments, but also companies. They cannot cope with higher bond yields. Now, the difference between the two lines is now more than 100 basis points. And I think, also suggested by some of the macro indicators, that the two lines will find each other again on their way down. Again, reflecting a lot of downside for bond yields. We can also compare the current bond yield to the yield on other asset classes. Now, this is done in the next chart. The green line shows the current 10-year US Treasury yield, and the blue line is the current dividend yield on US equities. Now, you can see that the gap between the two has become very large. In fact, it is the biggest in over 10 years. Now, this is important because in a multi-asset world, investors do not go in and out markets completely, but they shift their allocations towards those asset classes that have the best risk-return profile. Now, as yields have risen and dividend yields have not, you see that the risk-return profile of bonds has become more attractive relative to equities. This most likely means more inflows for bonds and, as a result, lower bond yields. This brings me to the end of this episode of Jeroen's Take. I hope you found it insightful. Also, I hope it helps you with your investment decisions. If so, please push the like button and don't forget to subscribe to my channel to receive updates about new videos. Thank you for watching. Have a great day. Bye.